Welcome to ABC Gluten Free. Thank you for joining us today. We're glad that you're here, and we're glad we're here too, actually. And we hope you're having a wonderful day. It did get a little cold in New Jersey this week, and we were hoping for that nice 80-degree weather that we had about a week ago, but so we're actually freezing today. But what we have on the menu for you today is going to definitely warm you up. We have a little bit of French and a little bit of Italian love, right, Sophia? So we hope that you guys B-Y-O-N.
Bring your own napkin.
Bring your own napkin because you're going to be drooling. We're making, you want to tell them what we're making?
No.
No. All right. Well, I have my super helpers here. You know Sophia and Jeremiah. And today we're going to get busy on a bunch of different things. We have a little bit of French, a little bit of Italian. We're going to be making for you some crepes. We're going to be making some pizza, right? And we're going to be making some delicious things that we want to share with you. We want you to write them down, write down the recipes, or check our Facebook page for the recipe, and then obviously make them your own. Today we're going to be featuring a really lovely product that we got. And Sophia, actually no, you didn't get to try it, did you? Jeremiah and I got to try it earlier.
What?
This is Rigoni's Yes, Iago.
What?
We got to try it.
What?
Yeah. Okay,
And
we had a bunch of different products that they sent us. Alberto, wait, let me just double check. Yes, Alberto, thank you for sending these to us. We have a dairy-free hazelnut spread.
That's really good.
Okay, so Nokia Latte, this is delicious hazelnut spread, non-dairy, which is very, very difficult to find, so we're really excited about that. That's a highlight for us today. And we have this delicious organic strawberry fruit spread, which, you know, if you read some of the packages and other labels of different products, you'll see all of the sugar and all of the nonsense that's in it. This is just strawberries, wild strawberries, apple juice, and pectin. And that's just really exclusive premium ingredients, and we love to have stuff like that. So thank you guys so much for sending this to us.
Can I try?
And then we got the organic lemon. I think it's like a lemon curd, a cross between a lemon curd and a lemon marmalade, and it's really delicious. So we're going to be fusing our French and Italian eats, and we're going to share them with you today with our crepes and our pizza, and maybe a little surprises in between. Are you guys ready to go? What do you need? Tell me. You're not tasting it right now. Girls love chocolate, and it's just a shame when you have to say no to them. So I might just have to let you have a little bit. What do you think? A little bit? No? You guys say yes or no? We want to know what you guys
say. Say yes!
You want to give Sophia a little heart,
yes.
A little love?
She said yes.
Gluten-free grandma said yes, so we might have to give it to her. Because even though grandmas don't overrule, we want to make sure that she gets fed well and that she cleans up our mess, so we might have to just agree with that. You want a little bit? You have to read it first. Go ahead, read it. No peel latte.
No peel latte, dairy organic hazelnut.
And where is it made? Italy. We love things made in Italy.
Oh my goodness.
It's nice and smooth, right? Don't drink too much. No, not enough.
No, thank you.
That's it. I draw the line. You don't get any more. Is that yummy? So it's a real big treat for us to have a dairy-free hazelnut spread. So thank you guys so much for sending that to us. We also have something that we made tonight. I am having a little bit of fun sister day today. We also made a nice roasted red pepper spread that we're going to be using on our crepes and on our pizza. So we better get started because we do have a lot of work to do today. I think we'll get started on the pizza first. We'll put that away. Tastes like chocolate, I know. All right, so for our pizza. Now you guys know we've made pizza in the past. We have a lot of requests. People have a lot of struggle with pizza dough, pizza crust. And you know, when it's non-gluten free, it's a struggle to gluten the yeast, to make sure it's active, to have the right ratio of yeast and flour and water and all of that stuff. So today we're going to try to simplify it for you because you're just going to have your gluten-free flour blend, whatever blend it is that you like. You're going to bloom your yeast. We have ours blooming here. And basically all we have in here is warm water, a packet of yeast, a little drop of oil, a little pinch of salt, and a little pinch of sugar. The pinch of sugar, yeah, because it hasn't sat very long. The little pinch of sugar, the yeast will feed off of the sugar. So remember that when you're eating a lot of things that are sugary and So we're gonna really make that simple for you. So you're just gonna take your gluten-free flour blend. You're gonna add it to the yeast with whatever liquid it is that you want to use. You could use water. You could use milk. It's up to you. It is gonna change the flavor and a little bit of the texture. We have a really nice big baking sheet. I want you to go get the pizza screen on the back, please. And Sophie, you'll need this here. And Sophie, you're gonna oil this up for us. So there's a bunch of different ways to make your pizza. You can do it low and slow and get a little bit of a higher rise to allow that yeast to work a little bit longer, because we're not gonna let this sit and let it rise for an hour like you would a regular pizza dough. Oh, here. So a regular pizza dough, you would actually make the dough, you would make it into those rounds, and then you would let them rise. And then after that, you would punch it down, and then you would work it out. And that pizza would still continue to do its thing when it's in the oven baking and when it's being worked on by your hands. When you put it into a really hot, hot oven, that crunchy crust that gets really super delicious, a little bit, gets really super delicious on the bottom, and then you get the inside that's nice and fluffy. So you kind of have to decide what kind of pizza do you want. And a pizza stone can make a lot of the difference in a home oven. If you don't have a pizza oven, if you don't have a brick oven, you can make a little bit of a difference with that pizza stone. Or you can use something like this, which is a pizza screen, which we use at our pizzeria. The pizza screen just allows air to get through to the pizza dough and to let it crisp up a little bit on the bottom. Some people will oil their pan and then put cornmeal on it to give it a crunchy crust. It's actually not making the crust crunchy. The cornmeal is the crunch that's in the crust. So don't confuse yourself with that. So it's really up to you if you want to use a pizza screen. We would still oil it. If you want to use a regular pan, like a baking sheet, then you would still oil it. It's up to you. But you want to make sure that you have it in all the corners so it doesn't stick. And if you're doing the pizza screen, you want to roll out the pizza first, roll out the pizza dough, and then put it on the screen. Don't press it into the pan. Like a lot of recipes have a pizza batter, not a dough. And that batter has to be poured into the pan, so you could not use something like this, because it would go right through to the screen, and then you would be pulling the pizza off of your screen, trying to eat it through the holes. So you don't want to have that happen. Alright, so today I'm going to keep this to the side, because I'm going to do probably a small one for myself, and then a larger one for the family. So what I have here is the yeast that's bloomed. I'm going to take about 3 cups of our gluten-free flour blend. Now use whatever you like. If you have something that you prefer, you have a quinoa flour you want to use, you have a white starch, a white rice, a brown rice flour mixture. That's good, honey. Yeah, that's good. So we're just going to add the flour to that. Mike, could you get me some water, please? And we're going to stir this up, and we're going to add some of our water. And now is the time, if you wanted to do some cheese, if you wanted to do some spices, that you can layer in to the actual dough, all of that. If you wanted to, bits and pieces of, you know, you could do butter, you could do bacon, you could do pepperoni. You can really do whatever you want. Thank you, Jim. All right, I'm just going to put a little bit of oil in here. You can use olive oil, avocado oil, canola oil, corn oil, whatever oil it is that you have in your house that you use that. All right. Now, in a food processor, this would take about 30 seconds. You're going to put everything in there, and then you're going to add your water to the top a little bit at a time. Sophia, do you want to stir while I add the water? Going. He doesn't want to play with anything. He just wants to eat it. So you can make your own individual pizza doughs. Or you can make the pizza crust ahead of time and keep them in the freezer for when your kids want pizza. You can make it up all ahead of time and wrap it in foil and then plastic wrap. Okay, you ready for more liquids? So we have about a cup and a half to 2 cups of liquid, and we'll see how much we're going to use. Stop going with the sides and just get the ingredients in the middle, please. And you can either dump this all out on your counter and do it if you want to make a big old mess, or you can put it in your food processor and just do 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and you'll have a nice dough ball. Okay. Now, Jeremiah, you guys want to put some spices in there or no spices? You want to get the spices? special ingredient. We have a beautiful mixture in here.
What's in it.
I won't. But it smells delicious. And if you want to make your own special ingredients, you might want to use things like parsley, oregano, basil, red pepper. I'm not telling them what's in yours. I'm just telling them what they might want to use in theirs. Mm-hmm. You might want to use garlic. You might want to use crushed pepper. So now is the time where you can get your hands a little bit dirty and just put them right in there. Push up your sleeves and let it go. And you want to call the kids down to get their muscles working a little bit. And you can give them each their own dough ball to make a pizza. Do you guys want to make your own or do
a big one? Yes, I want to make my own.
You don't want to do one big one for that?
No, I want to make my own.
All right, one big one because you're out. You're overruled. All right, so now if you get to the point where it gets a little bit sticky, which it's going to, you're going to want to add a little bit more flour. You know, we play the wet-dry game a lot, so you guys are used to that. So we're going to add a little bit more flour to that. That was about a tablespoon, and we're going to just let it go here. Now, this is when you want to get your hands into it. You want to put your hands in the flour. So if you want to... You're going to put your hands in the flour and you're going to get that dough. Hold on, Mom, you're getting that. We're going to take that dough out. Yes, you can. We're going to take our dough out. Sophia, would you get Mommy the flour? Now, you don't have to do this. This is totally like just because we want to have fun. Because this to us is fun. This is fun for the day. I'm going to need a little bit more flour. I feel it's so now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get everything from the inside of this bowl. Jeremiah, can you put the flour away, please? Just put it behind me, over there, please. And what I'm going to let Sophia do is I'm going to let her work it. She's going to work it. No, you're going to work it. We need more flour. She's going to work this dough. Basically, she's kneading the dough. Kneading the dough means that you're just engaging all of the yeast and the ingredients into the flour. Now, in a regular gluten pizza, you would be engaging the gluten and the ingredients to kind of come together. Since we don't have a gluten pizza, we have a gluten-free pizza, it's just a little bit different. Now, when we had our pizzeria, it took us quite a long time to perfect our pizza dough, but my brother got it to where it was spectacular. And it really is like an art and a science mixed together. So if you ever want to do a science project, this is the kind of project we like to do. The ones that you can eat. Alright, so I'm going to just knead the dough. I'm going to show you guys really quick. Like Sophia is doing back and forth like this. And you want to get a little bit of flour. You don't want it to be sticking. You want to flour your bench. Get some more. And if it gets too dry, then you're going to have to start to add a little bit more wet to it. But normally the oil from your hands, it will be enough. Alright, so we're just kneading our dough.
I think mine's neat.
Okay, so you're going to roll it out into a nice round for Mommy.
For you?
Yep.
Mom, I can make a different special shape.
No, this is it.
A different special shape.
You can make a different special shape, but I'm going to roll it out, and then we're going to put it on there. Alright, so I'm just going to take our pizza pan, and I'm going to start to press the pizza out into the pan. And I'm going to need some flour because it's going to start sticking unless you want to put plastic wrap on your hand and do it that way. Sophia's doing a really nice job with her pizza. So I'm just going to spread it out into this pan, and now you're thinking that's not going to make it in that pan. We're going to do our best to spread it all the way out. Go ahead, baby. You can do it. Now, for years and years, she came to the pizzeria even though she was just a little baby. I don't know if she really remembers much of our pizza guys twirling those pizzas, but we did have a lot of fun. Jeremiah, you might remember, right? You remember the guys? Yeah, Margarito and those guys twirling the pizza. Ooh, my grandma remembers going there. Jeremiah and I used to go there every day after school. And of course, we have to eat first before we get anything done.
Yes.
So we're going to just spread our pizza out. Now Jeremiah's got some of our sauce ready. We're going to do a nice pizza sauce on top. And now this is where your own personality is going to come
Daddy
into it.
Daddy taught me how to do like this.
Yeah. You want to make sure you get those toppings on there that are good for you. Now I'm just pressing the pizza slowly. Mm-hmm. I'm just slowly pressing the pizza to fit into the mold of the pan. Now you'll be able to see that when Jeremiah cuts and pastes on our YouTube channel. You'll be able to see what we're doing here, so a little bit better. But as you can see, I'm working my way all the way down.
You like a thick pizza, Mama?
I like whatever you make me. Now we have disputes about pizza very often. Thick crust, thin crust, Chicago style stuffed crust. I love Grandma's upside down pie. I like it a little bit Sicilian style. And I love sauce on the bottom and the top. That's just the way that I like it. Gluten free dad likes really anything, but a thin crust is probably his favorite. He likes that thin bar pie. You know, it kind of droops down and you have to like get underneath it to bite it. He likes that. You don't want it too droopy, but I do like it greasy. I'm probably the only one that likes a greasy pizza. Because that means you have pepperoni on it. Right, Sophia? Alright, so now's the time where I'm going to have to turn it and I need to go this way a little bit. Now if you feel like you're working really hard, if you have a rolling pin or you have a can, you can just take the can and go like this and you'll be done. It's not that hard work. You know, we just like to have fun with it and we like to show you all the different ways to do things and then you go ahead and make it your own by doing it your way. I never liked anybody telling me what to do, so I always like to tell people do it the way you want to. We're just giving you some ideas. All right. So I'm trying to get my pizza all the way to the edge here. Sophia's making a beautiful shape, and I think I know what it is. But I don't want to ruin the surprise.
I know you know what it is.
Now, we had a long week or so with Sophia being not well, and we had some family things going on. But we actually had a really nice Easter, so we hope you guys did too. We had very low-key. We didn't do a big dinner like we normally do. We just had some ham and potatoes. The kids will probably do this to you guys in the camera, right? You guys do thumbs down to ham and potatoes? Well, we had plans for fried calamari and all kinds of deliciousness, and it just didn't happen, right, Jeremiah?
And that was a big difference. A
big disappointment.
A big miss.
Big miss?
Yeah.
Big disappointment?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. To me, too. But I got a day off almost, right? Gluten-free grandma and I almost had a whole day off. We didn't even have to, like, put stuff in the oven. We just threw the potatoes in there with the ham.
Fire.
Yeah?
Hey, Mama.
So now, if you're wondering, you know, if you're in a... If you have a pizzeria or you have a restaurant or you have a food service business, how would you do a gluten-free pizza? There's a bunch of different ways. You really only need a very small toaster oven, a separate pan, separate paddle, just separate utensils is mainly the thing, and then obviously clean hands, and a clean workspace. The pizza crust can be made ahead of time, hold on, and put in the freezer, and then just taken out when you have a customer who has celiac or gluten intolerance, or is gluten-free and asking for a gluten-free pizza crust. Please, 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 don't get a gluten-free pizza crust and put it in the same oven, on the same pan, with the same hands that you made a regular pizza with. You're going to make somebody sick. It happens way too many times. You get a nice certified gluten-free pizza crust, and then you put it in the same oven, on the same pan, use the same paddle, and the same person with the same hands that have been in the regular flour. You're going to make somebody sick. So it's best to have, look at the space that we're using here. It's like a 2x2 space, a 2x4 space. It's all you need, and so you don't cross-contaminate. All right, so we're almost done. We're just getting our pizza ready. Jeremiah's going to put this in the oven. You guys didn't think I could do it, but we did it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, oh, honey, thank you. That's beautiful. Mwah. Did you show everybody? She made me a beautiful pizza. Now, I hope that the bottom, it doesn't go through. Are you guys pressing on it? Are you guys pressing on it? Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to poke some holes in my pizza. We're going to close up as the pizza comes to life. And then I'm going to ask Jeremiah to just put a little bit of oil on the top there. You want to do sauce now or you want to wait? It's up to you. You can bake the crust first or you can and then put the sauce toppings on it, or you can put the sauce and then put the toppings on later. It's up to you. But I think put some oil on that and bake it for like 10 minutes. So while he gets that in the oven, I might be out of breath because I was working that pizza crust a little bit hard. We're going to get started on our next item. I just wanted, did you clean your hands already? When did you do that?
Yeah.
Wow, that was good. I didn't get to do mine. All right, so we just want to clean up our space a little bit. So Kate, why don't you get the scraper?
Yay!
She's going to get the scraper and clean up our space a little bit. And then we can get moving on to our next item. We have some really nice recipes for you today. There's just so many that I had in my mind I couldn't decide. So the Italian and the French love came from wanting to do crepes,
and me.
Wanting to do tarts, wanting to do pizzas, and so many other things. I just couldn't decide what we wanted to do.
I told Mommy we should do pie, like strawberry pie, strawberry pie.
Strawberry pie, that sounds really good.
We're pie
pockets. Is cleaning that up. We're going to get on to our next. We're going to make little, what are we making? What are we making? Making pies? Do you want to make pies?
Or crepes.
Oh, well, we're ready with the crepes, but we can do the pies. We're going to do a little, quick little crust for you. Jeremiah, I'm going to have, okay, I'll take this. All right, that's good, baby. Thank you. Here, give it to Mommy.
It's healthy.
In a couple more weeks, everybody will start picking strawberries.
Yeah,
so you'll start picking strawberries, not yet, not blueberries. So we want you to have a pie crust that's very versatile, that you can use for sweet or savory, that you can use for a frozen pie or a baked pie, and it will be totally up to you which one you decide to do. So this is a very simple pie crust. We're going to do 1 cup of our gluten-free flour blend. Okay? We're going to do a half a teaspoon of salt. Put it in there. Thank you. We're going to do 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Now, this is if you want a flaky crust, a fluffy, flaky crust. We like ours that way. If you don't want a flaky, fluffy crust, that's a tongue twister,
fluffy,
then don't put the baking powder in there. Just omit it. We have about 2 ounces of butter. Now, if you're dairy-free, use the dairy-free butter. You can use Earth Balance.
Or you can use Kerrygold.
Or you can use Kerrygold.
I'm just kidding.
It's grass-fed 365 days of
the year. My Kerrygold.
Yep. Okay. All right, and we're going to do 1 tablespoon of sugar.
Yay! I got the big tea. Wait. 1 tablespoon of sugar?
Strawberries and yogurt,
yeah.
And in my coffee. So we won't have too much left.
Yeah.
It's a little sticky, right? You like that? She loves that on her strawberries, and we get the unsweetened, unflavored yogurt, and she loves it together with that. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to blend this up.
Blend it.
And I have ice water ready to go. Yeah, just with your hand. What happened to your apron? Alright, so you're just going to incorporate that same thing. If you have your food processor, it'll take seriously 30 seconds. And then what you're going to do is,
but if you have me, it'll take less than 30 seconds.
If you have a Sophia, a little minion in your house, it will really take less than 30 seconds. Speaking of minions, where are we going soon?
We're going to Disney.
We're going to Disney. And we are going to gluten-free our way around there. We're going to let you know all the top places to eat. And with the help of our friend Sarah from Gluten-Free, Dairy-Free Walt Disney World, who's given us so many tips and tricks before we get down there, we're very excited to have people like that will show us around and give to just get the water to blend the crust, okay? You want to just have enough water to blend the crust. So it's about 1 to 4 tablespoons. It depends on what kind of gluten-free flour blend you're using. If it's a heavier rice blend, it's going to absorb a lot more liquid. And you want to be careful doing that because water in your pie crust will sometimes cause it to burn. So if you're using water, it'll be a little bit more burn. If you're using buttermilk, it'll be a little bit more delicious. We don't have buttermilk today, so we're just using regular water. And we want everybody to be able to make this so everybody pretty much has water at their house and ice cubes, hopefully, so that's easier for them. All right, Jeremiah, we're going to take our little tart pans, please. All right, he has the pizza in the oven at 450? Or 400? So we have it on there. Normally, I wouldn't put these little tarts in at that temperature. So what we're going to do is we'll just mold them, and we'll put them in the refrigerator for now, and we'll get those in when the pizza's done. Luckily, we have some ready for you. Jeremiah, I'm going to need...
You want to crumble, right?
I'm going to need the brush with the olive oil.
No, you want to crumble, right?
Just make it enough. That's enough water. All right, so we have our little tart pans here. Now, you can call them whatever you want. Tartlets, tarts. What else do they call these? Gluten-free grandma tart pans? I don't know. There's fluted ones, scallop, whatever you want to call it. Not that, please. Thank you. We have little flat ones.
Both.
Little pie crust
tarts.
So, what would you like to make, Sophia? Want to make a fluted one, okay. Jeremiah, I have it right here, honey. You just need the brush. Thank you. Alright, so I have a brush that's already had some oil on it. I know these are non-stick, but you know, sometimes it just pays to do a little extra. And you know, you don't want to go through all this trouble and then have your pie crust stick. It's just very frustrating. And it's frustrating enough It's frustrating enough sometimes baking gluten-free that you don't want to have to throw away your ingredients. Okay, so I'm just going to oil up these. Hold on a minute, it's not ready yet. Alright, so this actually will make 4 to 6. So we want to make sure that you have, depending on the size.
Just a minute.
Alright, so she's right. You can take that dough and do a crumbly version and then press it in. But when you have the fluted, you kind of need a little bit more help there. Alright, Sophia. So she's going to take a little... We're going to take a little round, whatever you want to call it, a ball of dough, pie crust, and we're going to press it into the bottom. Now you're going to need a little bit of flour for your fingers. Here, baby. You're going to need a little, Jeremiah, do you want to make one of your own pie crusts here? Come on, Bubby. We'll get his hands dirty. We'll get him dirty. So we're just going to be pressing it into the pan. We're going to go up the side so we can get that nice little fluting. It's so cute when you have those little scalloped edges. And these are great if you're having a party. Even a birthday party, you can fill them with ice cream sundaes. But you can make these so way ahead of time and keep them in the freezer or the refrigerator, and they stay really nice. And if you want them to be warm, just toast them when you're ready to use them. These are easy. And the kids love to do them too, so they have a good time doing it. Sorry, I wanted you to move out of the way so they could. Alright, so I'm just going towards the edges. I'm coming up the sides, up the rim, so that we can actually get that nice fluting. So we hear actually the guy is doing grass today outside, grass and leaves. So we did have a nice couple of days where the grass started to grow and our neighbors are having their lawn maintained. So if you guys hear that, we know that it's just, nothing's blowing up in the back. We don't have an oven exploding or anything. Okay, so I've got my crust ready to go. What I'm going to do is to just hit some holes in that so the air goes through and the crust will cook nicely. Because we're going to do a blind bake.
There we go.
If you wanted to do something inside, then you don't have to poke the holes. You could just put your blueberries or your strawberries inside and bake it right in the oven. But we're just going to do the crust today because I want to show you what you can do with the crust. Jeremiah's going to put those on a baking sheet and the 375 for about 12 minutes. They're going to go in the oven. Guys, you guys all set? Okay, how'd you do, baby? Good? You have a lot of dough in there. Okay, here you go. And if you have a lot of dough in yours, it's going to kind of rise up. You'll really only have like a They're also teaching this type of an art form. They can express themselves, and there's not really many mistakes you can make other than it's just not tasting very good, which happens sometimes at our house, especially when we're experimenting. All right, you guys want to do the rest of these, and Mommy will get started on that next item? Or no, you want to do the rest of these? You want to just leave them? Jeremiah, you can put them on the baking sheet. Actually, you can put them right on here and take it away. You can take that away, okay? Please, thank you. Careful. All right, so for our next item... we're going to do our crepe, so I really want to get my West Bend heated up. Jeremiah, if you can give that to me, I would appreciate it. And for the crepes, it's just such a fun thing to do, but it is a little bit challenging. So if you're not, you know, comfortable with it, then just do a pancake style and roll it up or do whatever it is that you like to do with it. Thank you, honey. Now, I have been doing this today pretty much the morning, because I just haven't made them in so long that I wasn't really prepared to. But making monogat is very similar, and that's something that we like to do here. Monogat is probably our Mother's Day brunch recipe. If you're going to be tuning in for Mother's Day, we'll probably be making a nice monogat for you. So you don't want to miss that, because we love monogat. Homemade monogat is just delicious, right? You like that, right? All right, so I have my my West Bend at 350. I'm going to leave it for a second, and I'm going to just use my brush. I know it's nonstick, but it is old, and we are doing gluten-free, so we want to make sure that we have all of the steps necessary. Now, for the crepe dough,
there we go.
The batter. Very good, honey. Wonderful. Good job. Don't make it too dry, because then it will be good. You're going to you're gonna have to maybe put some oil. Alright, so for our crepe batter, I'm going to call it, because it's not a dough. It's very simple, and we did it in the food processor because we wanted to show you how easy it was. So I'm not going to actually do it in front of you. I'm just going to tell you what we did. I'm going to read to you the ingredients in case you want to go get a pen and paper. You can go ahead and write this down. Now, we have aquafaba in here instead of eggs. So we use our bean water instead of eggs. So once you let that sit, the bean smell does come up, but it doesn't change the taste of the crepe, which is what you're looking for. But we wanted to do an egg-free version. So we have about a quarter of a cup of aquafaba that we put right into the food processor, and we blended that up first to get it white and foamy and fluffy. That's what you want it to look like before you add the rest of the ingredients. Now for the rest of it, it was one cup of our gluten-free flour blend and about three quarters of a cup of either milk or water or dairy-free milk or whatever you want to call it, and about a quarter of a cup to half a cup we use seltzer. So actually we use San Pellegrino. So you're going to put that in there with a little bit of sugar, a little bit of salt, and I'll put the exact recipe up for you on Facebook. I'll make sure that I do that for you on Monday so you don't have to keep asking me. And we let that sit, and you'll see that the bubbles are going to come up, and then you're going to know that it's ready. You really have to let gluten-free batters rest for a little bit, because there's cornstarch and things like that in it that relax once you stop it from mixing it, and then they're stiffen up when you beat them. So you want to let that rest for a minute. Now we have a thicker version of what I really would have liked to do, but it came out and it tasted really good. So that's what's most important, not always how it looks. So we're going to actually be doing it in here. I feel this is a little too hot. I'm going to turn it down to 300. Yes. I'm going to put a little bit in here, and then I'll do it with this, and then I'll give you the brush when I'm done. Okay. So I'm just going to do a little bit of oil in here, and I'll give you that. And I'm going to actually just get a paper towel and get some of it out. It's kind of like how they do with the wok. They put the oil in, and then they do the paper towel around it. Okay, so now our pan is ready to go. This little trick of it was that I had to get my spatula in there. And it looks really super, super thick, but then I spread it out really nice and thin. I actually had, let me move this out of the way. I had it to where I was making a square instead of a round because I wanted to fold it up and make it like almost like a burrito. So I'm just gonna, if the pan was flat, it would be a little bit easier to do. It smells really good though. You can smell the sugar that's kind of getting crystallized in there. I'm just spreading it out so I have it even. Okay, honey, you can clean up that stuff, please. And then clean up in front of you so we can get ready with the crepes. Jeremiah, I'm just going to need a plate and a towel, please. So you want to just thin out your crepe, and you can see that I kind of made a square. A clean towel, yeah? And I'm just taking off the top here. I'm going to let that sit. The edges are going to get a little crispy. And that's how, I need a little bit of a bigger plate, but I'll take that towel. Sophia's got to clean this. You got to clean this up, okay? Now, what I'm going to do, normally, you can use foil, or you can kind of wet this and put it in the microwave to keep the crepes, to keep them moist. I'm just going to use the towel, and I'm going to fold them over into the towel once they come off of the griddle here. So now, if you have a pancake griddle, this would be really good to do on there. And it has a lower lip, so you could probably spread it out really nice and make a big one, kind of roll it up like a roulade if you wanted to. Alright, so I feel like the edges are getting a little crispy. I'm going to be able to pull this off. Now, I know you don't generally use a metal spatula with your nonstick pan, but I'm going to be very, very careful with it and not to scratch anything up. So I'm just lifting this off very gently. You can actually pull it off with your fingers. I'm lifting the whole thing up and I'm going to flip it over. And as you can see, we've got a little bit of nice brown, golden brown there. And a little bit of crisp on the edges, and I'm going to just kind of flatten it out. Now, we had a discussion today about what kind of crepes, right? What kind of crepes do you like? Chocolate, why don't you go ahead and take care of yourself? Be right back. We have chocolate. We have strawberry, we have lemon. Jeremiah, you were all about the lemon. We have a strawberry, we have a sweet and a savory, so we wanted to do both for you. So of course, I always wanted to go with the savory, unless there's chocolate involved, then I always want the chocolate. And we had a couple options. We have chocolate, strawberry, lemon. Then for savory, we have cheese, and we have, what was the other? Oh, our roasted pepper glaze. So I've gotten to where I'm spreading it out. And it's really nice with that. Thank you. Alright, so we've got that on there. Now, if you see, if you've ever been to a crepe place, have you guys ever seen them make crepes? Like, have you? When we went to Montreal, I think they made crepes. No. And they have a big round stone, so there's no lip. So they just pour the ingredients. It's very loose ingredients, very loose batter. And then they twirl it around with a wooden, like a stool. Like it's like a wooden dowel thing. And they twirl it around like that, and it just, it looks spectacular. It makes a really nice impression, and it really does taste delicious. So although our crepes may be a little bit thicker, and the batter's a little bit thicker than it normally would, they're still going to taste really yummy. I'm not a French pastry chef, so don't expect that if you're going to make the recipe at home. Just what you see here is what you're going to get. Alright, so I've gotten, the edges are a little crispy, and I'm going to pull it up very carefully with my metal spatula. I'm going to just go all around the edges until it comes up. Now, when you see that it's sticking a little bit more, you might want to wait it just a second, because it's going to kind of form that little crust on the other side, and that's what makes it really delicious. Now, if you wanted to, you could put butter in this recipe. Butter would really be nice, but we wanted to keep it gluten and dairy free and also egg free. No, we didn't put butter in this. Yeah. So I'm just going to pull it up now. Like, look, I can just do it with my fingers, no problem. And I'm going to flip it over and I'm going to let it cook on the other side. Now, what we have to do is, in order to. No, we have to get our pizza toppings ready. So why don't you, Jeremiah, can we get the pizza toppings ready, please? We need to get chopped onions, we need peppers. We have roasted peppers, we have pepperoni. Yeah. You're gonna have to make sure mommy's is on the top and yours is on the bottom. You put the pepperoni on? How did you do that? Oh. Alright, so why don't you get the vegetables and start cutting? She's singing me na nonna baby to the pepperoni. Only Italian girls do that stuff. Italian Jersey girls, I should say. Send us a message. Amy. She connected us with Alberto, and Alberto sent us some samples.
Was it nice?
Yes. And then that's how that all happened. And I had a really great conversation with Lori on the phone about Expo East. So if you're in town in Baltimore, Maryland in September, you want to get yourself to Expo East, and you'll find all new stuff like this out there. And really, Gourmet News Magazine is just filled with all gluten-free lines of food. There's so many different concepts and culinary creations coming out that you want to be the first one to know about it, so you might want to get to that Expo East. Okay, so we're going to cover that one up, and we're going to do another one. Expo East is the expo in Baltimore with all different kinds of natural products. It's a really fun thing to go do. It's like the gluten-free expos that we go to, but bigger.
Bigger.
Much bigger. Okay, so I'm doing another one. I'm just spreading it out. I'm just spreading it out across the bottom of the pan. I'm trying to make it as thin as I can because it does puff up a little bit. And I should have used the spatula that Sophia gave me, but I already started with this one. Once you start, you don't want to stop because it'll just start to clump up. Surgeon's assistant. Alright, so I'm just gonna. No, I'll take that, Sophia, when you need them. Alright, so I just want to spread across. I need a little bit of pressure on that. So now I've got a nice large crepe. Now I'm gonna let this sit because it's gonna have to cook for a few minutes. Now for our fillings, it's gonna be fun for us because we can do whatever we want, right? You guys are chopping, 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 chopping. Are you almost done? Do you mind just do a little bit of the onion so you can get it on the top of the pizza? Do a little bit of pepper so you can get on top of the pizza quickly, okay? Because we don't want to wait for the toppings to cook while the pizza's already, you know? You want to get your toppings on there at least 5 minutes before the pizza's done so they can cook a little bit. Or if it's a pepper, it can get a little nice and charred brown.
Hey.
We have our roasted pepper. Delicious. You can put this on your pizza. I'm going to put this on mine.
Yeah,
and if you don't have time to make a pizza sauce, which we use crushed tomato, tomato puree. Jeremiah made the sauce. Why don't you tell him what you put in the pizza sauce today, Jeremiah?
Tomato.
Tomato and spices. What spices did you use?
Oregano. Basil. Parsley.
Parsley.
And garlic.
Garlic. And what else?
And salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper. And he actually used a nice fresh piece of roasted garlic that we keep in the refrigerator just for when you need it. If you don't have time to make a pizza sauce, you can go ahead and grab one of these Don Pepino's pizza sauce. Now remember, if you have corn allergy, there's corn oil in here, so you might not want to get this, but this is one of my favorite pizza sauces. We got to try this at one of the food shows, and I really loved it, so we decided to get a number 10 can. You guys know that big, giant can. A number 10 can of Don Pepino's and play with it and try it. And the tomatoes are just really nice and red and delicious. They have a lot of sweetness in them, and I just really love that. Now, if you read the back, it's got garlic powder and spices and salt, and it says on the back, a gluten-free food. It's from Roseland, New Jersey, but I don't know where the tomatoes are from. I'm assuming it's Jersey Fresh, because it says it right there. I've never seen that on the can before, though. That's interesting. All right, so our crepe is cooking up a little bit. You can see the brown edges a little bit there. I'm going to try to pull it up now. It will pull up very easy on your nonstick pan. Why don't you guys get that stuff on the pizza? Put a little bit on mommy. So this is really nice. You always need a couple tries with your crepe. One or two to make your mistakes, and then the rest should be simply delicious. Yeah, you can do a little bit of mine. Ooh, you okay? Be careful, guys. Be careful. Alright, a little bit of, and you're going to do cheese or no cheese? Alright, so they have to get the cheese grated for their pizza. I have to get the cheese grated for my pizza. And if we want to do a savory crepe, we're going to do a nice, delicious, maybe a Dubliner or an Italian cheese in there. What do you guys like in that? That's okay. Sophia, why don't you let Jeremiah handle that, please? Jeremiah, you go ahead and do that. And Sophia, you come over here and clean up. Alright, so while they clean up the spilled peppers, don't go in there. Stay here, please.
No, I'm putting this one.
Okay. almost done. Sophia, come and decide about the crepes. I think we'll do that instead, okay? You let your mind handle the pizza. Why don't you move that stuff out of the way? No, no, move it all out of the way. Go all the way. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Now we actually have a little bit of space to do our crepe work. Now, if you want to do the crepe ahead of time. Delicious crepes. We have beautiful little fruit tarts that are going to be coming out soon. And we also have our delicious homemade pizza. Homemade pizza, don't make it a big deal. Just make it, put the dough in the oven and start baking it and put your favorite things on top. Sophia, here you go. Here's the napkins. You want to pass those out? Now the crepes are really big. I don't know if our plates are going to be sufficient enough, but we'll see. We also have some nice cream to go inside if you wanted to do a cream on yours. We have this So Whip, which my family absolutely loves, and we can put that into our crepes too if we wanted to. Alright, I'm just going to flip this over. Now Jeremiah's going to show you on YouTube how we cut and paste, how we cut and paste it to this point where you'll see the crepe is nice. It's very nice and pliable. It's also got a little crunch to it, and we love crunch like that. Alright, Sophia, you're going to go ahead and take one of the crepes that's done. Just take a small one or a big one if you're making it for Daddy. And I'm going to continue to make them. I'm going to make, I probably have enough for two or three more. So making crepes is not that exciting, but the exciting part comes when they're done and you get to fill them all up. You have to keep them under the towel, baby, okay? Thank you very much. Oh, what happened? Alright, so this one's cooking. I have it at 300. It's staying nice and hot. I'm keeping up with the oil on the bottom so that it doesn't stick or burn. Sophia, wait 1 second. Please stop what you're doing. Nobody can see what you're doing. She's taking a crepe and she's putting some nice wild strawberry jam on there. And what else are you going to put inside? So you do half and half. Do half and then chocolate on it. You're doing chocolate on one side.
No, it's
really. So you just want strawberry, gluten-free grandma? You want strawberry and fresh strawberries?
No.
I think she might like a little more salt on there. Always nice to have a little mascarpone in the house. Mascarpone and strawberries go really nicely together. Mascarpone and chocolate goes really nicely together. Well, it kind of goes with everything. But if you're dairy-free, you're not going to be using mascarpone. You might want to get Daya. They have a really nice little cream cheese that they sell. It's really nice. Okay, so I've got my edges here. It's not ready yet, so I'm going to leave it alone. And you can tell when you start to pull it up and it's still sticking, just let it go. It's not ready yet. It hasn't formed that little crust that it needs. Okay, you're going to give that to gluten-free grandma? Now, you can do your crepe however you like. I like mine rolled. Some people like theirs folded into that nice triangle. Some people just like theirs rolled up all the way into like almost like a ball. You're going to first like slice some strawberries on the top or on the inside? Inside? Okay. Sophia's doing a good job. So now she's going to stuff her crepe, and I was going to, Jeremiah, you want to stuff your crepe? Or are you busy right now?
I'm doing English first, Mom.
Fix his house. He doesn't know. He's making pizza back there. He's too strawberries very beautifully. Jeremiah, you want to get our tarts out of the refrigerator too? We can put those around. Hopefully we'll have our pizza to eat. Otherwise, gluten-free Johnny and gluten-free Grandma are going to be starving. We're not going to fill up on a crepe, that's for sure. But you can do breakfast crepes, are really nice. Savory crepes, you're just going to, you can take out the sugar or leave it in. And you can make your ingredients on the inside nice and savory. Alright, Sophia did a really nice crepe. Now you want to fold it over or roll it? Fold it over nice. You want to give her a little cream on top? You want a little cream? You want to figure out? Got a little salt lip on the top.
No.
Just got more scoop on the inside. We also have a little cinnamon. You can do a little cinnamon on top. Okay, Sophia, get a spoon for this. Soap whip, if you let it sit out, the cocoa whip is really nice, and it has a beautiful texture, and you just kind of whip it around a little bit before you put it on anything. And then why don't you show them before you go away, Sophia, show them what you did. Yeah, but you're going to give it to gluten-free Grandma. This is Sophia's. All right, hold on, let me show them up here, Sophia's beautiful cream that she made. Go ahead. What are you going to do now? What are you doing next? Got one more here. I'm going to take this one off and I'm going to do one more, I think, and that's going to be it. They take a little bit of time. You have to have some patience for that.
Patience is a virtue.
Do you have that virtue?
I don't know.
She doesn't know. I think she does. Sometimes. Alright, I'm just going to turn this around like I showed you before. I'm going from the inside to the outside and making that round circle. Trying my best
there
with
we
my
go.
Spatula.
Now try.
Okay. Why don't you show them and give it to them? Go ahead, that's beautiful. Sophia did a beautiful job. Thank you, honey.
Oh my goodness.
Alright, now you can do Johnny next. So, six, I think we made, and if you made it a little bit looser, you would get maybe one more out of it, but as I told you before, it was really, really loose, and it just wasn't cooking up properly, so I wanted it to stay a little bit thicker, because I wanted the flavor to be there, I wanted the flavor to be really good. Alright, these are our little tarts that we made, fruit tarts. Jeremiah, do we have one that's big that I can do, or not?
Not yet.
Okay, so I'm just going to explain to you what I did with the tart. I took the tart shell, I put a little nucolata on the bottom, I layered it with strawberries, a little tiny bit of mascarpone on top, and a little bit more of that chocolate powdered sugar on top, and these are ready to go. So if gluten-free Grandma or gluten-free Dad want one of those, they can have those. Do you have your crepe? Is it delicious?
Delicious.
Strawberries and mascarpone inside is good. Sophia's doing a strawberry and a lemon this time. That sounds really yummy, Sophia. That's for Daddy. Does he like it rolled or folded? Which one? How do you like it, gluten-free Dad? Rolled or folded? You don't know? Maybe I'll do a savory crepe since you guys rolled.
You want the strawberries in it?
You want strawberries inside, gluten-free Dad?
Whatever you make.
First, we'll top gluten-free Dad with some so whip, right? He definitely wants that. He wants the whole container on his. Go ahead, Sophia. You're doing a great job. All right, Jeremiah, you want to come and make a crepe, or are you busy?
Nah.
Eat it. Do you want to make a crepe or no?
Not
right this second. You're too busy. Hopefully, he's making us something to drink back there. I would like a nice raspberry. I would like a nice raspberry something. Ooh, Sophia, that looks great. Now, we have a little tirani that we can put on the top. You want to put some tirani on top for Daddy? There's raspberry tirani syrup. A little bit. Jeremiah, can I have the raspberry syrup? Thank you to tirani for sending us these beautiful syrups. We are having a blow with them.
That's for
we have sugar-free and regular. We're just going to drizzle a little bit on the top You can actually mix this with some powdered sugar to make a little bit of a glaze. You can mix it with your chocolate to make a raspberry chocolate hazelnut, or you can mix it with your soda and make a little raspberry. That was a lot. Oh, gluten-free dad, I hope it's good. All right, bring that to the gluten-free daddy.
Your room's pizza?
No, but I'll make room.
Okay.
All right, this is my last crepe. I'm going to just put this one up.
I'm going to make a strawberry and cheese.
Go ahead, baby. What kind of cheese?
Cherry.
Really?
Of course.
You're doing strawberries and cheese. She might need a little balsamic glaze on that.
Pork?
All right, Sophia's going to do Kerrygold. Okay, I think she's going to do the spreadable one. Thank you, Beth. You going to do this one?
No.
You're not going to spread it on?
No,
oh, she shredded. I'm sorry. That's what I told you in my email. All right, so we're going to need a grater. Sophia's going to do strawberries and a little scallop. This is going to be delicious. Can I have a grater? Thank you, buddy. Oh, why are you giving this one for? Disney this grater. I like a box grater. I'm a box grater kind of person. I might as well grate some on my plate since we're here. And I want a savory one. I think I'll do maybe some cheese and chocolate. That might be good. Here you go. Ready?
Wait, you
didn't
know where we put them on.
Cheese on mine. Ew, cheese lady, cheese girl. Okay, that's enough. Alright, that's enough. Now I have my crepe right in here. I'm gonna just take that off the hot burner. If gluten-free dad can come and get this for me, I appreciate it. We can get rid of this hot item. And then we can get eating, because it really is time to eat. So I'm going to take, is there one for chocolate or no? There's,
yeah, that.
Okay. So I'm going to take a little bit of that chocolate. I'm going to just put it right on there. Oh my goodness. You didn't know that cheese and chocolate was a thing, did you?
I knew it.
Cheese and chocolate. I love sweet and savory together. And I like mine rolled up. So I'm going to roll up mine. Because I like to just pick it up and eat it. The other way around. Well, I usually feel mostly Italian. Is it coming after mine? You don't want strawberries, right?
Cocoa with the...
Yeah. I'm going to keep eating mine.
Of course. Why did I even ask?
Mmm. Oh, Jeremiah. Why don't you move this one? Show me.
Into your stomach.
Delicious pizza, Jeremiah. It's awesome. Look at this. So today we used to rigoni di asti. Rigoni di Asiago. I don't know what's the matter with me today. I'm having tongue twisters. We used their delicious chocolate hazelnut spread. The wild strawberries are amazing, and the lemon spread. I'm really loving the lemon spread. I'm thinking that could make a really nice little tart. The ones that we made with the strawberries. Are you going to eat that? Is that delicious, Jeremiah? Oh, that looks good. How's that, Sophia? Yummy? Cheese and strawberries. She made her own connection, her own concoction. Is that yummy? Want to bite, Jeremiah? And this is when we're excited, because everybody can have everything that we've made. Because it's gluten-free and egg-free, and we have our selected dairy that we can have. So today we were using that to show you. It's just yummy, right?
Pizza.
You guys know it's time to go, right? Yeah, we'll eat pizza when we're out. Thank you for your help, Sophia, today. Thank you so much. Thank you, Jeremiah, for helping and cleaning up the mess. Thank you to gluten-free grandma and gluten-free dad for always sitting and watching and cheering us on. And of course, for cleaning up our mess. We hope you enjoyed the show today. We made for you delicious, beautiful strawberry tarts with our delicious, delicious chocolate hazelnut spread that we absolutely love.
Delicious.
Our yummy pizza, which has everything on it that you can imagine and a little bit more. And our beautiful crepes. We did a sweet and we did a savory. You want the recipes, go to our Facebook page and click on the actual link for the show. We'll put the recipes in the comments so you don't have to go searching for them in a file or someplace that you won't find them. We thank you guys so much for joining us today. We hope you enjoyed the day, and we want you to come taste and see how good it is to be gluten-free. Have a great weekend, everybody. Ciao.
Ciao.
Aprons by REM Designs. Hair by Satneek. Makeup by Artistry. Thank you to our pantry partners and fridge friends. Follow us on livestream, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, and YouTube at ABC Gluten Free. ABC Gluten Free is a production of American Vibes. Ciao.
God bless everybody. Have a delicious